When traveling along the Deschutes River, you just might spot a herd of horned friends traversing the cliffsides. However, the bighorn sheep we see today were sorely missing from the landscape not too long ago. During the 19th century, Western immigration had a big impact on native bighorn sheep numbers. Unregulated hunting, habitat loss, and diseases contracted from domestic animals resulted in Oregon's bighorn sheep population being wiped off the landscape by 1915. But in 1954, the Oregon State Game Commission reintroduced bighorn sheep to Oregon from British Columbia. The bighorn herds we see along the Lower Deschutes today were reintroduced using the very same methods back in 1993. Now, with a thriving population, translocation efforts are still made to supplement other bighorn populations across state and international divides.
So, Andrew, why are we giving up our sheep to other states?
Sure. Well, we're really lucky here in the Deschutes Canyon. We've had a population that's been kind of on the exponential increase. So we have a surplus, and one of the ways we can help kind of reduce our herd or slow our population growth is translocate some of those animals. And Nevada had an area that they needed some help, so we're happy to help with them.
There's a lot that takes place. I mean, the first thing that we're looking at when they come in is we're getting weights on them to assess their health. We'll be taking blood samples, nasal swabs for any kind of bacterias. We're actually taking a clip of the ear for genetics, just to be able to know where these sheep originated because of the movement that we've had.
All of these biological samples are to make sure that these animals are actually healthy enough to be translocated. ODFNW doesn't want to take any sick animals and transplant them into a population, you know. So they want to make sure that these animals are healthy enough to be transported.
This population here was reintroduced in the early 90s. So it's cool to have something here that was here long before any of us were back on the landscape. Also, it's probably, one of the biggest draws to the canyon, whether people are coming to fish or float. Really cool to see them. But also, you know, we also harvest the population, so it gets to a point where there's sustainable harvest, and it's nice to be able to provide that opportunity for us.
This population down here on the Lower Deschutes is one of the largest populations that we have here in Oregon, so it acts like a source population. So Oregon Department of Fish and Wildlife is able to translocate some of these animals and supplement populations elsewhere. And that gives those animals in different states the opportunity to, you know, get that genetic diversity to adapt to the environment and to combat diseases and whatnot. And if it's successful enough, that population will be able to increase over time.
What do you want people to know about, like, the work that, you know, everyone's doing out here?
Honestly, I think one of the coolest things about the Deschutes Canyon is just, you know, it's habitat-wise, it's amazing to see when you put an animal back in a habitat that it's been gone from, you just let them go. They do great, you know. It's, you know, a lot of other species we work with are not doing as well, or it's a struggle. It seems like you're always kind of fighting a decline or struggling to keep them where they're at, whereas these sheep, it's nice to have a bright spot where, you know, it's a thriving population, they're really visible, people can, you know, easily see them from the road when they come down here, so just kind of nice to have a kind of feel-good story.
So you're proud of your sheep?
Oh, I mean, yeah, absolutely. I think it's one of the highlights of the area, for sure.